bloggers. Stay with Gemma as she gets the latest from the UAE's biggest influencers.
Well, in anticipation for International Women's Day coming up on Friday, March 8th, I want to shine a light on the inspiring female entrepreneurs leading the way here in Dubai. And of course, that includes Bemi Giwa. Thanks for coming in today.
Thank you so much for having me, Gemma.
Now, first up, tell us about your baby. Metaphorically speaking, no surprises, Catfish. Yeah. So how did this concept evolve?
Catfish has evolved through my love for food. I actually started off my food journey by my food blog Dubai Food Foodie, which I launched in 2014. And through that, I've been able to explore much of what Dubai has to offer when it comes to food. But speaking of food, I've been largely influenced by my parents. And growing up, it was a thing we had to learn how to cook as girls. I don't know how I feel about that, but it's something, a topic for another day. But I really enjoyed that experience of growing up in an African home, cooking every day, you know, making lunch for my dad, just cooking for everyone. It was just a beautiful experience. When I moved to Dubai and, you know, I didn't have that anymore. I was in school here. There was no family lunches or dinners, and I would often cook for myself, but then all my friends would start coming to my room and coming to eat my food. And
literally, charge yeah. For it.
But it was always a vibe, was always a thing. So that's how my blog launched. And at the back of my mind, I've always known I wanted to have a food concept, but being in Dubai, it can be quite tricky setting up one.
So you wanted to try and mimic that feeling of home here.
Yes.
With a place where people feel comfortable to socialize, but even bring the same tastes and values of growing up in Nigeria.
Yes, exactly. And my experience as a wellness blogger really influenced that as well, because a lot of our dishes are, you know, properly balanced, not as carb heavy as you will find, like most family meals are, you know, more comfort food, but this is more on the healthy side. But we still put a lot of influence on our flavor, and we use organic where possible, you know, we don't use any soy in our food.
And is this what you mean by healing foods?
Yes, that, and the fact that a lot of the ingredients that we use are ingredients that are used commonly at home for healing purposes. So when it comes to African traditional medicine, food is often used for healing. So you have native doctors who make concoctions and potions,
yeah,
to cure like headaches. There's a cure for, you know, back pain, body pain, and it's all through food.
Oh wow, very interesting.
Yeah, so a few of the ingredients that we use at Catfish are things like amaranth. Amaranth is
a grain, isn't it?
Yeah, but we're using the leaves, and this is actually really, really popular in West African cuisine. The dark leafy green has tons of benefits, so it's like African kale, if I may. And we also have a huge jollof influence, and jollof is, I don't know, like, have you tried jollof?
No, it is a fruit, isn't it?
No, it's not. So jollof is, how do I describe
this? I have something in my head, but maybe I'm not thinking of the right thing.
So jollof is basically rice that's cooked in tomato sauce, and the whole process of the cooking is very smoky. You have hints of spice there, and it's just, there's no Nigerian party without jollof rice. But at
Catfish, okay, so I've got to try this.
Yeah, you definitely have to try it. We have jollof rice, but we also have lower carb options like jollof cauliflower rice and jollof quinoa, and we also have jollof hummus, which is actually a hit.
Oh gosh, so forget going to the doctor. Just go and book a table at Catfish and all your ailments will be solved.
Food is power.
Now, Bemi, the name though, Catfish, where's that stem from?
Catfish has been influenced by a few things. First of all, catfish is my dad's favorite fish, so we cooked a lot of catfish growing up.
Yeah.
And also, I just kind of like that play on words. Catfish, you know, the whole pun thing where you got catfish. I just think it's really cool.
Yeah, and I do. I know. I love a good name. That's why I wanted to know where's it from. And I like the sentimental value as well.
Yeah, so I settled on that and it works.
Now, you mentioned before you've called Dubai home now for over 9 years.
Yes.
But as you mentioned, of course, you're largely influenced by your African roots as well.
Yes.
So how have you tried to combine the two to create an even larger impact with your mission to spread wellness awareness? So you've spoken about you have Catfish and that's incorporating the health aspects to food that you were brought up on.
Yeah.
But what opportunities has Dubai brought for you to spread that message or that understanding that has been instilled in you because of your African background?
Yeah, I mean, I think Dubai has been fantastic. I'm so grateful. Again, being quite young, the opportunities I've been able to have here have been amazing in terms of, you know, being able to connect with people on a corporate level in a higher in higher places than I would have expected to. I think that being in Dubai, if you have a mission and you have a vision, and you're passionate, you have that hustle in you, you can actually make things happen much faster than you would anywhere in the world. And there's that acceleration factor in Dubai, which I'm very grateful for.
So, yes. Yeah. But as you say, you know, sure, Dubai offers you that platform, but you certainly need to credit yourself for having that hustle.
Yes.
Because if you sit around all day, you won't achieve. So well done to you, Bemi.
Thank you.
And lastly, just before we jump to a song, Bemi's Kitchen. Now, this is another initiative you co-founded. What is the strategy behind it? So this isn't like Catfish. People don't come knocking for more food.
Yeah.
So explain to us Bemi's Kitchen.
Okay, Bemi's Kitchen is, it really was an opportunity that just kind of happened. What we're trying to do is Bemi's Kitchen is try to provide more authentic African food. And but Catfish is more my interpretation of how I would like to eat, you know, as someone who's into fitness, but I still want to have food with flavor. Bemi's Kitchen is taking things a little bit back and more to the roots. So yeah, really excited for that.
And you're also involved in that consultancy.
Yes.
So you help brands build up, a bit like an F&B mentorship program.
Yes. So basically what we do is we do a lot of content creation for F&B brands. So we do a lot of social media. I have some pretty fantastic clients that I work with and I've been working with for a while. And it's more about conceptualizing brands, which we've been able to do with Catfish and a few other brands, which I really can't mention, but yeah.
Exciting. Well, exactly. You have firsthand experience launching your own Catfish.
Yeah.
So perfect way to spread that knowledge as well. Bemi Giwa, who has graced the covers of Women's Health and Emirates Woman, been listed in Alan Hot 100, nominated for Stylist Arabia Fitness Influencer 2017 and 2018 nominee for Cosmopolitan Fitness Influencer of the Year. I'm out of breath. Now, are you telling me the magic is in Afrofit and all this while I've been wasting my efforts at Zumba? What's the situation at? Come on, give me the secret.
Listen, Afrofit is an entire vibe. Afrobeat is just a movement now that's coming out of the urban Africa and moving to the streets. You have Afrobeat influences in all the top hip-hop songs now, and I created Afrofit as a way to kind of bring that music and dance together. I love dance. I've been dancing all my life, and being Nigerian, like, we hear the beat, we just want to move. So the class is not Zumba. We say it's not Zumba.
And you're the teacher, aren't you?
Yes, I'm the teacher. I don't teach anymore. But I'm working on a super cool project which will continue to bring dance and music together here in Dubai.
Is this a live performance of Catfish?
Oh, it will not be a performance. It will be an ongoing thing. But I feel like in the past year, I've had to move from doing things myself physically to just kind of building things where people can do them, right? And just create a platform where I can bring more people together, because that's the way I can be more effective. I just found that I was doing too many things. But with this project, we're going to make Afrofit big in Dubai in a way that, no one is expecting, and I'm pretty excited for it.
I'm excited. Yeah. I want to try this. Sounds amazing.
It's the best workout.
High intensity, isn't
it? High intensity, lots of hip movements, and we combine that with dance moves. If you've ever watched traditional African dance, you see that it's very energetic. There's a lot of jumping. Your legs are all over the place. Your hands are moving. But it's all about the vibe. You have to feel it. Forget about everything else. It's you, the music, and the beat.
The rhythm is running in your buds. Yes, please sign me up. Now, to top it off, Bemi, you're also the author of blog DubaiFitFoodie.com.
Yes.
What keeps you motivated to maintain this when you have so much else going on as well?
Well, at the moment, I'm actually not writing on Dubai Fit Foodie anymore. Like I said, being an entrepreneur has taught me so many lessons, and I keep learning every day. So with Dubai Fit Foodie, I've had to, you know, take it off for a while. It's been about 3 months since we took it offline, and we're planning on relaunching it in about 6 months. I'm actually going to get authors in, writers in. I'm getting a team behind this to actually bring my vision to life the way that I want it to be, because I can't grow it sustainably with myself, with everything else that I have going on. So that's the story behind that one. I think sometimes to grow, you need to cut back.
Exactly. You cannot run yourself to absolute exhaustion.
Yeah.
So it's a very mature and, I'd say, smart way to run your businesses.
It was quite painful doing that, but
I understand that too. Everything is a baby that you have nurtured, but that's the next step. And as you say, to make it grow and to project it to the levels and of success that you desire, that is taking that little step back. But I mean, you are the captain behind it all, so for sure. So long as you're involved, it's going to take off.
I hope so.
Now, of course, we said earlier, International Women's Day, it's coming up this Friday. I think you'll agree there's only one way to dream, and that is big.
Yes.
So got to ask you, have you still set your sights on achieving a spot on the 30 under 30 Forbes list?
This is my ultimate dream. I've written it on my board. 30 under 30 Forbes list. I want it and I'm going to get it.
With that attitude. So you have a vision board.
Yes, I have a vision board.
Have you always had that? Do you believe the power in a vision board?
I've not always had that. I have lots of notes on my phone and I believe in the power of notes on your phone.
I like that, because I was going to say, I have a never-ending list. There's my vision board, always being updated.
But I do believe in the power of words, and I believe in the power of kind of like visualization, you know. Think about it. Next thing you know, you're doing it. And, you know, like, just believe that if you want it, always have that at the back of your mind. Always think about it. Just keep on dreaming about it. You can be anything that you want to be. It's all about you.
And who's been a significant role model in your life?
I have so many influences. I have to give a big shout out to my mom.
Oh, yes. We always have a say to moms. Agree.
She's
They're
amazing.
Phenomenal.
Super strong woman. And she's always told me, you're the daughter of a lioness. Just go after what you want. Literally, no weakness. Do what you need to do. Always, always go after what you want to do. And yeah, that's always at the back of my mind. Plus, I don't want to disappoint her. So.
Oh, that is beautiful. No, you go. Oh, gosh. Look at all these accolades already. No way at all, Bemi. But it's been an absolute delight.
Thank you
for giving us all this motivation on hump day.